Let's take a look at this laptop base. We are going to take a look at creating this chamfer. From here, it looks pretty ordinary. But if you follow the chamfer all the way to this end, you can see that it blends smoothly into the main face, creating a vanishing effect. In this video, I'm not going to create the whole solid. I will just be focusing on creating the surfaces involved. Let's start with this planar surface body. At this corner, we have a small tap. This small tap is important in creating a smooth transition. On this face, I have prepared a sketch of the outline of the chamfer. This sketch represents how the chamfer looks from the top. It is basically an offset of these edges. If you look at the final result from the side, we can see that the outer edges of the chamfer actually curve downwards. So we need to find a way to project this planar sketch onto a curve. This seems like a job for the intersection curve command. Before we do that, let's create that curve. Begin a sketch on the right plane. Project this edge. Click on Look At to return to a view normal to the sketch plane. Begin a fit point spline. Attach a first spline point to this projected point. And end the spline beyond the offset sketch. In order to get the best transition, we need to make the spline curvature continuous with the projected line. Go to Constraints, Curvature. Select the spline and the projected line. Since the intersection curve is a 3D sketch, we can begin a sketch on any plane. Go to Create, Project Include, Intersection Curve. Select the spline as a first curve. For the second curve, select this chain of sketch lines that represent the outer edge of the chamfer as seen from the top. Let's add a spline and the offset sketch. We want to give more guidance for the loft. Go to the sketch palette and check on the 3D sketch option. Begin the straight line command and start creating rails between these points. activate the Surface tab, go to Create Loft. Start lofting from this horizontal edge of the tab to the 3D sketch lines. For reels, click on the select box. Check on the chain selection option. Select this chain of edges as the first reel. Select this chain of sketch lines as the second reel. Since the spline is already curvature continuous with this edge of the tab, we can leave the continuity option for profile 1 as connected. For reel 1, since we want a sharp edge, we should leave that as connected. In order to get a better look at the transition, we can go to the render workspace.